What's up, everybody? Carolina Jackpot checking in. It is October 17th, 2017, Tuesday morning. I'm going to go over a quick recap of the week 7 picks and predictions against the spread.
Week of October the 14th, 2017. This was one of those crazy weekends in college football. It seems like you have every year where nothing seems to go right. None of the picks go right, and there's a ton of upsets. However, I don't think we did necessarily that bad considering what some of the results were. Let's get into them. South Alabama at Troy. I picked the Trojans to cover the spread. They didn't do it. Lost the game. Clemson's at Syracuse. Same thing here. Picked Clemson to cover the spread, and they got upset by Syracuse on Friday night. My lock, stock, and two smoking barrels might as well not been. Washington State absolutely got the crap beat out of them by Cal on Friday night late. That one wasn't even close. South Carolina at Tennessee, Gamecocks covered the spread. Got that one correct. Gamecocks moving on to 5-2 on the season with a 15-9 victory in Knoxville over a Tennessee team that is reeling. Michigan at Indiana, Wolverines did cover the spread. Florida State at Duke, they did cover the spread as well. However, they didn't win that game by as much as I thought they would. Eastern Michigan and Army got this pick incorrect. Army did win the game, but did not cover the spread, though. Eastern Michigan was a really tough team. Boston College at Louisville, another upset. 45-42, Boston College wins in Papa John's Cardinal Stadium. So that 21.5-point line was out the window. Louisville not too good this year. I'm not going to pick them anymore. Here's another head-scratcher. UNLV and Air Force. Air Force did end up winning this game, but they were down 20-0 against UNLV. How are you behind 20-0 to a team that lost to Howard? I don't get it. Purdue at Wisconsin didn't cover the spread either. Oklahoma and Texas, this one was a correct pick. The Longhorns did cover that spread. They lost by 5 in the Red River rivalry. Georgia Tech at Miami, that was a 1-point win by the Hurricanes, so they didn't cover the spread there as I thought they would. Georgia Tech is, there's something else. Auburn at LSU, the Bayou Bengals covered the spread there and won the game, which didn't surprise me. I thought that they might. And Navy at Memphis didn't cover the spread there, did pick Memphis, but they won by 3, not 4. Texas A&M in Florida, I thought the Aggies would win the game and cover the spread, and they did just that. Arkansas, Alabama, blowout, 41-9 win by the Crimson Tide. They did cover that. This is one that got away from me, Vandy and Ole Miss. I think that was 57-35 was the final score of that one. So Ole Miss covered the spread. Vanderbilt didn't. They disappointed me. I thought their defense was better than that, but apparently not. Missouri at Georgia, this was a decent pick, I felt, at Missouri would cover the spread. I felt they'd come out and try to do some things, and they did. They had some big plays in the beginning. This game was actually tied at 21 in the second quarter before Georgia just, you know, started running the ball down their throats and exposed that weak defense for what it is. But it wasn't enough to cover the spread. However, they could have. Kirby Smart doing the classy thing down there inside 2 minutes left to go. They just started taking a knee. And going into victory formation with still like a minute and a half left on the clock. They could have easily scored another touchdown and covered that spread, but they did not. Too bad. Boise State and San Diego State, they did not cover the spread. Another head scratcher. Boise State won that game. Upset the Aztecs. Good win for them. Cincinnati at USF, South Florida, the Bulls. Figured they would cover the spread there, and they did. They won that game 33-3. So, on the week, 9-11, not too great. I'll have to compute where I stand on the year. Give it a frowny face. I don't know. That's all right, though. We'll cover the frowny face up. That's not that bad, considering all the upsets that there were in college football this week that nobody would have predicted. I mean, you know, nobody would. That, I mean, come on. Nobody would have thought that Cal would have beaten them. Just like this. No one would have thought Syracuse would beat them. You know, covering the spread is a different thing. But at any rate, guys, I'll put some more picks and predictions for week number 8 up today. Got some good games going on this weekend, and
should be a lot of fun. I will see y'all later. Peace. And I'm out. Go Gamecocks.